Good wishes, dear students. In part 3, class 10th economics, now I will discuss with you equilibrium price. For understanding equilibrium price, we have to understand demand curve and supply curve both. Now, demand curve. In my part 1, I have already explained you demand curve. Now again, I am refreshing you what is demand curve over here. Demand, as I have told you in part 2, that demand is inversely related to the price. That is, when price rises, demand decreases, and when price decreases, demand increases. And supply is directly related to price. That is, when price rises, supply also increases, and when price decreases, supply also decreases. Here, in this demand curve, what is demand curve? I have already explained you, now again I am telling you. See here, OX axis and OY axis we have drawn, and in this OY axis is price axis, showing the price of a commodity, and OX axis is the quantity axis, which will tell us that at what price, how much quantity is demanded. Now, here you have seen from top above 600 price is there of any commodity. At 600 price, see what will be the units demanded. That will be 50. 50 units of any commodity will be demanded. Now, when price decreases, when it goes down from 600 to 300, demand increases. See, this is coming to this, and if you will join it with OX axis, here it will come to 60 units. When price further decreases from 300 to 100 rupees, see, obviously demand will increase of any commodity. At 100 rupees price, see how demand is increasing. It is going there, and if you will match it with OX axis, it is coming to 70 units. So you have seen that as price is decreasing, demand is increasing. And when you will draw a slope joining this adjoining of OY and OX axis, one slope will be made which will slope downwards towards right. Slope downwards towards right. So demand curve has this property that it always slopes downward towards right, showing that when price is decreasing, quantity demanded is increasing, and when price is increasing, quantity demanded is decreasing. Understood? So this is represented by DD curve, which is known as demand curve. This is figure 1. Now comes figure 2. In this figure, supply curve has been shown. See here, OY axis again price axis, and OX axis is quantity axis. Now here, any commodity price can never be zero. That's why this supply curve, SS, is supply curve, and it is not originating from this point as compared to here. Here also it is going to downward. Now supply is going towards opposite direction, but it is not originating from this point, because at any given point of time price of commodity can never be zero. So here we have taken as 100 rupees as the starting price of any commodity. Now at this price, 50 unit is the quantity demanded of any particular commodity. When price is increasing 300, see, and when you will draw a line towards OX axis, it is falling at 60 unit. So obviously you will see that as the price is increasing, demand is also supply is also increasing of a commodity. See here, this is a quantity supplied, so it is also increasing. Now when price further increases from 300 to 600, then if you will see the graph, you will see that quantity supplied has further increased to 60 to 70 units. So this is the supply curve, which is opposite, like this way. This is the opposite to demand curve. Demand curve is falling downwards toward right, and supply curve is increasing towards right. Understood? Now, the equilibrium price, when we have seen these two figures, when we combine these two figures, equilibrium price will be taken. Here, the equilibrium price is the price at which quantity demanded by the consumer equals the quantity supplied by the producer. This is the point where both sellers and buyers are happy with the price and quantity. Equilibrium price is the optimum point where both supplier and consumers becomes happy, because supplier, as you have seen here, the equilibrium price has been shown, and the intersection point of this demand and supply is this point, which can be represented by E also. So here the price is 500, quantity supplied is 5. So here at this point, whatever price, whenever price will increase, suppose price increases to 800. So if we will take from supply side, supply will increase to 8 units. See here, 800. Now this point has been joined to supply curve. And when you will see, when you will follow the point from there to OX axis, that the supplier axis, you will see that it has increased from 5 unit to 8 unit. So optimum point is the point where demand and supply intersect each other, they meet each other. So at this point, consumer becomes happy, because whatever they are paying for a commodity, they are getting maximum benefit in terms of utility at this point. And from supplier side, if you will see, at optimum point is the best point, because there whatever they have done the costing, that has become equal to revenue. So at this point, whatever supply they will increase from here, at this point, whatever supply they will increase, they will fetch more profit. So when every supplier wants to reach the equilibrium point as fast as they could, and at that point, consumers are also well satisfied, because they get best utility at that point. Whatever they are paying, they are getting benefit of it. So this is the equilibrium price, where demand curve and supply curve meet each other. Okay, so this was the demand and supply which I have discussed with you, and this is chapter 2. So you can study at home and prepare yourself well for your final examinations. Okay, students, thank you so much.